Hi, my name is Luciana. I'm a program manager working on the Python extension for Visual Studio Code. And in this demo, I'm going to go over remote collaboration using LifeShare in Visual Studio Code Spaces. At the time that I recorded this demo, Visual Studio Code Spaces was named Visual Studio Online, but it has been renamed to better reflect the capabilities of this really amazing platform. So every time I say Visual Studio Online, it's just the same thing as what we have now as Visual Studio Code Spaces. So now I'm going to let Luciana and Kim from the past to make this presentation for this demo. So LifeShare is an extension for Visual Studio Code that allows you to edit and debug in a collaborative way with others in real time. And Visual Studio Online is a platform that allows you to have that same experience, but from any kind of device that supports a browser. So I'm going to join my colleague Kim to show you how this collaborative experience works, the combination of these tools, LifeShare, Visual Studio Code, and the Python extension, and then joining all of that, but in Visual Studio Online. So I open Visual Studio Code, and I open a file through file, open folder, so I have it here. But now I'm here with Kim.
Hi.
To show how we can collaboratively work on a Flask application. So I have this Flask app here, and I'm going to install the LifeShare extension. I already have it here installed, but if you don't, you can just look, open the extensions view in Visual Studio Code, type LifeShare, and I really like the extension pack because it installs other extensions that are very useful for this collaborative experience, especially around these times when most of us are working remotely. This gives a very nice experience. So once you install it, you can start a collaboration session by clicking on the status bar here. So I'm going to click here and it's going to start that session. And it already copied the invitation link to the clipboard. So I'm going to send this to Kim. He has joined the session, and we can see here that I have this chat open, and I can come here and talk to her if we have anything to chat about in regarding the code. And I can also follow Kim's movements. So if I click here, every movement Kim will do inside the code, I'll be able to see it and follow it. So right now I see that she's deleting a comment there, so that's nice. That's really cool. So I'm going to start running this application to test it out to see how it goes. I already have a debugging configuration to run this application in Visual Studio Code, but if you'd like to learn more about how to create debug configurations with the Python extension, we have a demo for it. I'm going to start then debugging by hitting on the green arrow there. And it started the server for me. So I'm gonna open that link. So now that I did it here, I'm gonna close this chat so I can have more room. I'm gonna try this app. So we can see here that once I press the button, the dog paw will not let me. So awesome. Now coming back here, Kim is making a change and she's changing it to a cat. When she saves it, we can see that the web server is gonna reload to apply these changes, even though I'm on the debugging server. So that's pretty neat. Now, when I come back to the application and refresh it, I'm gonna see that her changes were applied. And now we have a cat not allowing me to press the button. So that's awesome. So in this demo, we've seen how you can use LifeShare to have this collaborative editing and debugging experience with your coworkers all in real time, and how you can use the Python extension Visual Studio Code to get live reload support for Flask applications even while you're debugging. In this case, we've seen it working with Flask applications, but the same thing supported with Django. So now we'll take a look into how it looks with Visual Studio Online and how it allows us to create and set up an environment in a very, very easy way. So in Visual Studio Online, you can start a dev environment based on a GitHub repo. In this case, if I want to work with this application, then I can easily just pass it on to Visual Studio Online, and it will pick up the requirements.txt file and will create a virtual environment for me in a very easy way. So let's take a look into how it works. So I have this application that I want to work with on GitHub. So I'm going to open a new tab and go to visualstudio.ms/visualstudio-online. If you haven't signed in for the first time, it will just ask you to create an account and sign in. You do have free Azure credits to play around with it and try it out. So I already have already done that, so I'm going to start by creating an environment. I'm going to call this the cat said no. So I'm going to go here to the link, and I'm going to copy the link for cloning this repo and paste it here. So I'm going to leave with these default configurations and create this environment. So we open Visual Studio Code on the browser for me. So that means I could be using it on my cell phone, my tablet, anywhere, not only my laptop. So this brings that development experience to any device that supports a browser. So that's really awesome. And we can see here that it already created an environment for me. So I'm going to install the Python extension to make this experience even better for my Flask application. So I'm going to type Python, and I'm going to install it. And I'm going to reload the window. So now when I open a Python file, the Python extension will activate. And I'm going to select that environment for my application so we can start using it. Now I'm going to open the terminal. And I'm going to create a new one so I can get the Python extension to activate my environment for me. And I can see here that if I type python-m pip freeze, it had already installed all the dependencies that I need that it got from the requirements.txt file. So that's really awesome. So now I'm going to start a collaboration session with Kim again. And again, I'm going to click on the status bar to start that. And once I have the link, I'll send it over to her. So Kim has just joined us, and she's also using Visual Studio Online on her machine, which she can access from any device that has browser support. So now when I open a file, I can still follow Kim around and check any changes that she makes. If she opens a different file, we can also see that behavior happening. So I can see that she is making changes and removing code. This gives us a great collaboration experience overall. And we've seen how you can easily set up development environments through Visual Studio Online, and you get the same experience you have locally, but this time from any device. You can do it from a tablet, from a cell phone, anything that supports browser. And you do need an Azure account to use Visual Studio Online, but once you sign up, you get free credits, so you can try all of these out for free. So try this out today. Visual Studio Code and LifeShare are available with no cost. Visual Studio Online, you can easily just get free Azure credits to just try this out and see how that experience goes for you. And let us know how it goes. Thank you.